Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, I'd like to welcome a great friend of mine, Mrs. Dogo Zambata.
Send me love, send me love, send me love, send me love.
Get off and talk on some Bumble right now, guys. Come on, come on, come on. Hey!
Good morning, good morning, good morning, everybody. Good morning to you all, early risers. We are grateful that you are here this morning. I greet you all in the precious, mighty name of our Lord and Savior. It's good to see all of you. I see many people here this morning. I see Sis Mambulelo, Sis Sali, and my lovely wife. They are here this morning. Sis Pusi Mklanga, Mendo, I see Excelsia Sikobi, I see Osno Nokekana, Mtswaneti Mudimula, I see Miriam Mabena, Hudisani Rarushai, I see Mr. Ndaba Msalili is awake, I see Sestebogo Mapala. Good morning, everybody. Mr. Mukubedi, hey, Mr. Mukubedi, we are praying for you. We are believing God with you, man of God, and we know that God's hand is upon your life, and by his stripes you were healed. Not are healed, not we will be healed, but you were healed by the stripes of Jesus. Thank you, sir, for waking up this morning. We also see Zandi Mbata. Hey, welcome, Sis Zandi. Zikodo, Nechituni. Sis Zikodo, thank you again for waking up. And Nomsama Naring, Kimberly Damini, and Mr. Dugisani Sibata Kotsimnena, good morning. It's good to see all of you here this morning. I'm excited this day because I know that God is on our side. I know that we are victorious. Just like the song says, you know, we overcame the devil by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of our testimony. And I think that's the position that we need to assume all the time. We need to, you know, take that position of victory and say, you know what, I'm victorious. And it's not based on how I feel. It's not based on what's going on in my life. It's based on what God said. God said, I'm victorious, and that's who I am. We got to keep reminding ourselves all these things all the time, because the Bible says you are victorious. You are victorious not because you won the battle and, I mean, you fought the battle and won it, but because Jesus fought the battle and won it for you. He was doing it for you. It was for you when he was on that cross, and we are victorious in the name of Jesus. Come on, somebody shout amen wherever you are. You are victorious. Shout amen with your victorious self. Hallelujah. Praise God. Now, let's go to the Word of God, and then we're going to have some time of prayer this morning. I want you to turn your Bible, or I want us to turn our Bibles to the book of Exodus chapter 14. Exodus chapter 14. I'm reading it in the New International Version, but you could be reading it in another version. In Exodus chapter 14, verse 1, I might read a couple of verses and jump over to other verses. And I really encourage you just to go dive into this whole chapter, you know, in order for you to have some context and perspective. But verse 1 says, the Lord said to Moses, tell the Israelites to turn back and encamp near Pi Hahiroth between Migdol and the sea. They are to encamp by the sea, directly opposite Baal Zephon, and Pharaoh will think the Israelites are wandering around the land in confusion, hemmed in by the desert. So God is very specific here, and listen to me very carefully. God is very specific, you know, on what he needs the Israelites to do. He tells them exactly, you know, where they're supposed to be because he's on a mission. Come on, somebody say he is on a mission. So God gives specific instructions. He gives these instructions to Moses. He says, Moses, tell my people, this is the place they need to be at, you know, next to the sea. They are to encamp by the sea, the scripture says, directly opposite, you know, Baal Zephon. So he says, when they stay at that particular place, this is what is going to happen. Pharaoh is going to think that the Israelites are wandering around the land in confusion. Now, Pharaoh will think that the Israelites are confused, whilst God is confusing the enemy. Come on, somebody. Are you hearing what I'm saying this morning? So God is going to give you some instructions and some things that he might say to you might not, you know, necessarily be the common things to do. The things that God is going to, you know, tell you to do might not necessarily be the coolest things to do. But God will be setting you up. God is setting you up, you know, to confuse the enemy. I know the instructions he's giving you might be a little confusing, or there might be, you know, something that you are not used of or used to. But God is saying, just follow me. Go to Hahiroth between Migdol and the sea. I hear the Lord saying to some people watching me this morning or with me this morning, say, God is saying to you, I want you to go at this and this place. I want you to speak to so-and-so person. I want you to keep your mouth shut. I want you not to do the following things. God is saying all of these things to you, child of God, because he wants to confuse the enemy. Now, the Bible says in verse 4, and he said, God says, I will harden Pharaoh's heart. So whenever you follow God's instructions, God is doing something behind the scenes. Now, the best thing you can ever do to for yourself, or the best gift you can ever give to yourself, is just follow the instructions like a baby would follow the instructions. Never question things. Never say, you know, why, Lord, are you doing it this way? I've seen you bless somebody in this particular manner. Therefore, this is how your blessing should come to me. Don't prescribe to God how your blessings and how your answers and how your solutions are supposed to come to you. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Just follow the instructions, because God is doing something behind the scenes. Now, in this case here, God says, I will harden Pharaoh's heart and he will pursue them. He says the devil will still pursue you. The devil will still come to you, you know, like a flood. He will still come to you, you know, like a ton of bricks. Then the Bible says, but I will gain glory for myself through Pharaoh in all of his army. God is saying, you know, even when things are coming against you and you're feeling like you're overwhelmed, you're feeling like, you know, you're swamped, you're feeling like you're drowning, God is saying, that's the moment where I am going to gain glory for myself through the challenges that you go through. And the Egyptians, the world, Babylon, your enemies, the Egyptians who were the enemies of the children of Israel, will know that I am the Lord. So the Israelites did this. The Bible says, you know, when you follow instructions, then the world will know that I am your God. Come on, somebody. God wants to fight your battles. God wants to show you. God wants to show his strength in your life. And the key is for you to follow instructions. Now, listen to what the scripture says. I'm jumping over now to verse 13. Verse 13. Then Moses answered the people, do not be afraid. There's a context to this. There are verses that you need to read before you go to verse 13, and I will give you some synopsis of that. So he says to Moses, says to the people, do not be afraid, stand firm, and you will see the deliverance of the Lord will bring for you today. The Egyptians you see today, you will never see them again. The Lord will fight for you. You need only to be still. Now, after, you know, the Egyptians started pursuing, you know, the children of Israel, remember, even when God gave the instructions to the children of Israel, the Egyptians still pursued the children of God. Now, or the children of Israel. Now, God says to them, he gives Moses specific instructions again. He says, I need you to keep charging on. I need you to keep going. And the Pharaoh and his officials are going to come after you. And all the horses and the chariots and the horsemen and the troops, they're going to pursue you. Now, he's referring to the children of, you know, the Egyptians who are going to pursue the children of Israel. And the Bible says, you know, the Egyptians, they overtook the children of Israel. You know, they overtook them as they camped by the sea near that place that I told you about, opposite Baal Zephon. And the scripture says, as Pharaoh approached the Israelites, he looked up and there were the Egyptians. He saw the Egyptians marching after them. Or these Israelites, when they looked up, they saw the Egyptians marching after them. They were terrified and cried out to the Lord. You know, remember, even after they encamped at that place, part of them were saying, you know, we don't know if we are safe in this place. Only God knew what he was doing. Now, you could be in a situation right now and things are happening and you're not sure whether you're going to come out of that situation. You're not sure if you're going to overcome in that particular situation. You are not sure, you know, if what God told you, you know, is really, 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 really going to happen. And that's what the Israelites were doing. And that's the same position they were. They looked up and there they saw the Egyptians who were marching after them. They were terrified and they cried out to God. And they said, Lord, and they said to Moses, Moses, we know that, you know, we were in Egypt. And, you know, there seemed to be like there were no graves there. And you brought us to the desert to die. They said, you know, did you just bring us to the desert to die? What have we done that you have brought us here in this land? Did we not say to you in Egypt, leave us alone. Let us serve these people. Didn't we say to you, God, didn't we say to you, God, you know, I know that my part is to struggle. I know my part is, you know, to be in this situation. Didn't I say, Lord, don't take me out of this place. And then God says to them, hey, listen to me. Do not be afraid. I hear the Lord saying to someone this morning, regardless of who you are seeing around you, regardless of what you are feeling in your body, regardless of the challenges that you are experiencing right now, some of you might be, you know, in a very tight spot right now. Maybe you are feeling pains in your body. Maybe some of you right now, you just don't see a way out of your situation. Maybe some of you right now, you are faced with a terrible case, at the high court, and they are accusing you of something you have not done or something that they are just pushing you to do. Maybe some of you right now this morning, you know, you're faced with a situation concerning your children or concerning your family, concerning your husband, concerning your wife, or concerning you, concerning your job, or, you know, concerning whatever it is, and you're asking yourself, how am I going to survive this situation? How am I going to, you know, come out strong in this situation? Hey, listen to me. God is saying, it doesn't matter what you see. It doesn't matter what is surrounding you. Just don't be afraid. Just don't be afraid. And then he says, stand firm. Stand firm. Stand firm in me, and you will see the deliverance of the Lord that he will bring to you this day. God is saying, I have a deliverance, you know, a card that I'm going to show you. I know that the enemy might think that you are surrounded. You know, you might even be thinking, not only just the enemy, you might even be thinking that there's no way out in here. The Lord is saying to you this morning, you will see my deliverance. You will see how I'm going to deal with this. This is my battle. This is not your battle. This is my I'm gonna do it for you. I'm gonna do it my way. And hey, listen to me. God has never lost the battle. God does not lose any battle. God does not lose any patient. God does not lose any case. God does not lose any situation. God is saying, you are going to see my deliverance that I'm going to bring you today. God is saying, you are a candidate of my deliverance. You are a candidate of my miracle today. I'm talking about you. Don't be looking at someone else or don't be thinking about someone else. God is saying, you who are here and who are going to be praying with me this morning. God is saying, I'm going to show you and I'm going to bring my deliverance to you because you're too special for me not to deliver you. You are too special for me not to do something for you. You are too special for me that I am obligated to do what I said I'm going to do. That he says, this is the verse that many people like. He says, the Egyptians you are seeing today, you will see them no more. The Egyptians you are seeing today, you will not see again. He says, again, you will never see these people again. After I have sorted them out, after I have dealt with them, after I have, you know, clapped them, you will never see them again. God is saying, I'm about to clap your enemies this morning. God is saying, I'm about to do a miracle for you this morning. God is saying, I'm about to do what only me can do, that says the Lord. God is saying that I am going to do what man cannot do, what man will not believe, what even your enemies will not believe. They will be thinking that you have got the greatest thing, you know, greatest inyanga or greatest whatever it is. God will be people will be thinking that when you have, you know, special places in high places, or you have got special people in high places, the way that God is going to do it for you, they will think that, you know, you have robbed your way up. You have, you know, cheated your way up, or you have bribed your way up, or you have done something, you know, in order to appease people, because God will be doing it for you. And yet they will not know that it is the Lord's doing. And it will be marvelous in your eyes. Child of God, I want you to be encouraged this morning. Child of God, I know we're living in hard times, we're living in difficult times, but I want you to be encouraged this morning. Child of God, I want you to know that the problems that are surrounding you today, you will see them no more. The Egyptians you're seeing today, you will see them no more. Why? Because God is for you. God is on your side. And then he says to the children of Israel, just stand still. I am here this morning. I woke up this morning to encourage you that just stand still and see the deliverance of the Lord. Just stand still and know that God is for you. The other scripture says, you know, just be still and know that I am the Lord your God. God is saying, I am the Lord your God. Don't you understand? Don't you understand, child of God, that I am there for you? Don't you just understand that I am El Shaddai in your life? I will provide for you. I am your Jehovah Jireh. He is saying, I am your Jehovah Rapha. I am your healer. I know that that sickness seems so big because even the doctors, the specialists, told you that they don't know what to do with you. But he says, don't you know that I am your Jehovah Rapha? Don't you know that I am your peace? I am Jehovah Shalom. I know there are many things that are, you know, shaking you, shaking your mind and shaking your life. Just stay still in God. Do not be afraid and stand firm in God because he is your Jehovah Shalom. He is the Most High God, El Elyon. He is El Shaddai, the God that is more than enough. He will do it for you. He takes pleasure in doing it for you. He takes pleasure in coming through for you. Don't you understand, child of God? God takes pleasure. No one forces him to come for you. God will come for you all the time. As long as you reach out to him and you stand by faith, you are not afraid, and you stand firm, he will come through for you. I don't know who this word is for this morning, but I believe that God wanted you to hear this word. I know these are difficult times. I know that. I know that. I am very much aware that these times are difficult times. But hey, listen, in Goshen, you and I, because we are in the city of Goshen, we are in the place of Goshen, we are going to experience abundance in the midst of all of these things. We are going to experience the abundance of peace, abundance of health, abundance of provision in any way that God wants to provide for us. And you are a candidate of that. You are a candidate of miracle from God. Stand firm. I want us to pray this morning, man. I am so encouraged by this word. Even I needed to hear this word. I am so encouraged by this word. And I believe that God is encouraging you this morning. Even before you go to work, even before you start your day, just know that the Egyptians that you are seeing today, you will never see them anymore. That's the word of the Lord for somebody this morning. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Hey, listen, we're going to be praying this morning. We're going to be praying for, you know, a couple of things. I just wrote down here that, you know, we're going to pray that the Lord may help us to stand firm. And I know standing firm, you know, it takes a lot of courage. It takes a lot of courage to stand firm. So I want us to pray that God may help us to stand firm in his promises. Stand firm in our faith. Stand firm in him. Believe him. Believe his word. Believe that what he said he will do, he will do. So prayer item number one, let us pray that the Lord may help us to stand firm. They have the courage to stand firm in our faith, even in line with these verse that I have read here in Exodus chapter 13, verse 14. Exodus chapter 14, verse 13. And number two, I want us to pray for the body of Christ, or I want us to pray for our brothers and sisters to be consistent in their love for God. You know, it's very easy that when things are not going right in your life, just to start looking at alternatives. People start looking at alternatives. And I want us to pray that God may help us to stay consistent, you know, in our walk with him, consistent in our faith, consistent, you know, in following instructions and obeying God, consistent, you know, in being doers of the word of God, consistent in prayer, consistent in whatever God is instructing us to do. So I want us to pray that God may help us to be consistent. And thirdly, I want us to continue to pray for our nation. And I know some of you might be saying, but Pastor George, we've been praying for our nation for a long time. But I want us to continue to pray for our nation. It's our duty and our responsibility to pray for our nation. And as we pray for our nation, I want us to pray for our leaders, the leaders in our nation. The Bible says we need to pray, you know, for those that are in leadership so that we can lead a peaceable life. We can lead a life full of peace. So we got to pray for those that are in, you know, in authority, and pray, you know, for the many things that this nation is faced with. And we pray for our world, because it is in us praying for our nation that God will come through. The Bible says, if my people that are called by my name will humble themselves and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways. The Bible says, God says, I will hear them from heaven and I will heal their land. God says he will hear us when we pray for our nation. And number four, which is the last thing, I want us to pray. I want us to pray for our friends, our family members. I want us to pray for our churches. I want us to pray for our pastors. I want us to pray for Mamfundisi. I want us to pray, you know, for, you know, our family members, our parents. If your parents are still alive, I want you to pray for them. I want you to pray for your siblings today. I want you to pray for them and say, Father, I pray that they may come, that they, if they are not born again, I pray that they may be born again. You know, if there's anything, you know, if your mother is not feeling well or your dad or whoever is not feeling well in your life, I want you to take that stand of authority and pray for them in the name of Jesus. Amen. So that's what we're going to do this morning. So we're going to be praying right now, you know, for a couple of minutes, and I believe that God is going to hear our prayer. Father, we just thank you this morning. We give you the praise, oh God. Oh, Rabba Kasata la Mandro Koshita la Babarian. Bandiriba Kasata la Bacose Telebegerian da la Bosa. Ribaba Mandoro Boshi Kelebegerin da la Babasik. This is the day, Lord, that you have made, that we may rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day, O God, that we are victorious in. This is the day, my God, where we're going to see the Egyptians, you driving away the Egyptians. This is the day that, Lord, that the Egyptians that we are seeing or we have seen, we will not see them again. And Heavenly Father, we are so grateful. We are grateful for the things that you have done, and we are grateful for what you're going to do, Lord. We are grateful, Father, for your mighty hand. We are grateful, Father, for your willingness, my God, to come through for us, the willingness, oh God, in the name of Jesus, to drive away our enemies, to deal, my God, with every situation that the enemy has thrown at us. Lord, we are grateful this morning to know, my God, in the name of Jesus, that we are victorious. There is a way out because, Lord, you will provide a way out. Lord, you have provided a way out. Lord, you keep on providing a way out, oh God, in the name of Jesus, in every situation. It doesn't matter what is happening right now in Ukraine, and you know, it doesn't matter what is happening, Lord, with the supplies of raw materials and everything. It doesn't matter the confusion and things that are happening in our world today, but Father, our trust is in you. Father, I pray that help us to stand firm in your word. Help us, oh God, in the name of Jesus, to be courageous, to stand by faith, even, my God, when we are surrounded, even as we look up, oh God, we see the Egyptians pursuing after us, even as we look up, Lord, and we see all these challenges and the problems and the many things that surround us, Lord. And Father, I pray that even as we see all of these things, that we can stand firm. Help us not to be afraid. Help us, my God, to stand by faith. Help us, Lord, in the name of Jesus, to have faith in you, Lord. Help us, oh God, in the name of Jesus, to continue in your ways and not in the ways of man, but in your ways, Lord. Help us, oh God, in the name of Jesus, to stand firm and we may behold and see, my God, the deliverance that you will bring to us today. Father, I thank you for the deliverance that you're bringing to many that are even praying with us today. Thank you for this great deliverance, Lord, that you're showing us, oh God. Thank you for this great work that you're doing even with your people. Thank you, my God, in the name of Jesus, that you sent forth angels even for your people this morning in the name of Jesus. Thank you that you're confusing the enemy, God. The enemy is in the state of confusion right now. He doesn't know what to do, Lord, in the name of Jesus, for we are standing firm. We are not afraid of what the enemy is trying to do. We are not afraid of him pursuing at us because we know that, God, our deliverance, we will see our deliverance, Lord, your deliverance for us. You will deliver us, my God, in the name of Jesus. And you are bringing the deliverance to us today. And Father, we are so grateful, oh God, in Jesus' name, that even as we have been delivered, oh God, from all of these things that surround us, Lord, we know, my God, that the challenges, the situations that, Lord, we are experiencing today, Lord, we will never see them again in the name of Jesus. Help us, Lord, to stand firm. Help us, my God, to consider your word and not consider the things that are surrounding us. Help us, Lord, to consider your promises, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Help us, my God, in the name of Jesus, to stand firm in your word and stand firm in our faith and stand firm, God, in faith in your word and faith in you, Lord, in Jesus' mighty name. And Heavenly Father, I am praying this morning. I'm praying for the body of Christ. I'm praying for these, my brothers and sisters, these ones that are praying with me. Heavenly Father, I pray for them in Jesus' mighty name. Even those, my God, that are not praying with me. Even those, my God, that will be watching this broadcast, my God, at another time. Father, I am praying for them in the name of Jesus. I'm praying that, Lord, we may stay consistent, my God, in our love for you. Help us, Lord, in the name of Jesus, to be consistent, you know, in faith. in walking by faith, Lord. Heavenly Father, help us to be consistent in obeying your word. Heavenly Father, help us be consistent, Lord, in the name of Jesus, in serving you, Lord. Help us, Lord, to be consistent in winning souls, my God. Help us to be consistent in our prayer life. Help us, Lord, to be consistent, Lord, in the name of Jesus, in doing your will. Help us to be consistent, my God, in the name of Jesus, in standing, my God, in your word. Help us to be consistent, my God, in every area of our lives, in the name of Jesus. Every area that pleases you, Lord, help us to be consistent in, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Help us not to be shaken. Help us not to be moved, oh God. Help us, my God, not to sway from one place to the other place. Help us not to be tossed to and fro by every wind of doctrine. Help us, Lord, in the name of Jesus, to stay focused in your word. Stay, my God, in your word at all times. Stay, my God, consistent, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Stay, my God, constant, knowing that you are a constant God. You are a consistent God. You loved us, my God, then, and you're still loving us right now in the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, we praise you. Heavenly Father, we honor you. Heavenly Father, we know that you never leave us nor forsake us. Heavenly Father, we know that you are there for us in the name of Jesus. We know, my God, that even in this time, thou art with us in the name of Jesus. Rabo kasa talabashi telebekesa. Mandiri bakala mandrobo kotise leborian. Riba mandorobo koshila mandrobo kosia. Lerebebe keshe teleborian dalabasa. Menderebo koshila mandrobo kosia. Menderebo koshila mandrobo kosia. We know, my God, the blessing of the Lord maketh rich, and he adds no sorrow with it. Heavenly Father, I am thankful this morning that, Lord, your blessing that is upon our life. The Bible says we are blessed going in and blessed going out, Lord. And Heavenly Father, we thank you that that blessing is on us. Just like you said you will bless Abraham, Lord, you have blessed us, my God. And the blessing does not add sorrow in our lives, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, I just thank you for the many things that you're doing today. I just thank you that you are for us and you are not against us, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Father, we lift up, my God, our families to you. Father, we're praying for our family members. We're praying for our cousins. I'm praying, God, even for my sister. I'm praying in the name of Jesus, even for her children. I'm praying, God, for her in the name of Jesus right now. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray that you strengthen her, Lord. I pray that you be for her, my God. I pray that you provide for her. I pray, God, let your provision, oh God, be seen every single day in her life in the name of Jesus. I pray, God, that even her family, my God, may be strong, Lord, in the name of Jesus. I pray, God, that, Lord, whatever her heart desires are, Lord, I pray that you provide for them. I'm praying, God, for my family-in-law, Lord. I pray for my sisters-in-law. I pray for my brothers-in-law. I pray, God, in the name of Jesus for them. I pray, God, for my mother. I pray for my mother-in-law. I pray, God, in the name of Jesus, even, God, for our families, our extended families. I just pray, God, in Jesus' name, you know their needs, oh God. You know that which, my God, in the name of Jesus, they need to be experiencing. And Heavenly Father, today I am praying for them, Lord, in Jesus' name. Those that don't know you, God, as their Lord and Savior, I pray that they may be born again today in Jesus' mighty name. I pray, God, that you send laborers across their path, that they may be born again in the name of Jesus. Oh, la rabo kasata la mandorobo. Siblings in the name of Jesus. I'm praying for them. I'm praying, my God, for these siblings in Jesus' name. I'm praying, God, in Jesus' name, that you may come through, God, in Jesus' mighty name. We worship you. We praise you. We honor you, for you are glorious and you are wonderful. You are mighty in the name of Jesus. There is nothing impossible with you, Lord, in Jesus' name. I'm praying, God, Father, those that are still in the dark, those, my God, I pray for them in Jesus' name. That, Lord, you may take off the shackles that are binding them. I pray that they may be free. I pray that those that, Lord, seek deliverance, I pray that you may deliver them, my God, from the clutches of the enemy in the name of Jesus. I pray that they may be set free. I pray that they may surrender their lives to Jesus. Many of those of my family, Father, who don't know you as their Lord and Savior, I pray that they may have an encounter with the Lord Jesus. I pray, God, that they may open up their hearts, even as you, Lord, are knocking at that door. I pray that they may understand and know, God, and let this revelation come to them that you are the way, the truth, and the life, and no man can go to the Father except by you. Father, I pray for their salvation. I pray that they may accept you as their Lord and Savior in the name of Jesus. I pray for their healing. I pray for their protection, Lord. I pray that you protect our parents, Lord. I pray, God, that you may provide for them, even in old age, my God, in the name of Jesus, I pray that they may not suffer, oh God. I pray that you protect them. I pray that you provide for them, Lord, in Jesus' mighty name. Heavenly Father, this morning, and Lord, I am praying, God, right now for our nation. I pray for the nation of South Africa. I pray, God, for the president of this nation. I pray, God, in the name of Jesus, for the cabinet ministers. I pray, God, that let there be a change, my God, in the status quo, my God, in this nation. I pray that let there be a change in the hearts of ministers. Let there be a change, oh God, in the name of Jesus, in the hearts, in the heart of our president. Let there be a change, my God. And the change, Lord, I pray that let there be a positive change. Let it be a change, oh God, in the name of Jesus, that is meant, my God, to traject this nation to a place of peace, a place, my God, of no corruption in the name of Jesus. I'm praying, God, that the Lord, every leader, every person, oh God, in leadership, Lord, I pray, my God, that they be of one mind, and let there be, let them be, my God, of that mind of seeing this country prosperous. Let them be of that mind, Lord, of not just concern about their interests, oh God. I pray in the name of Jesus that they may be concerned about the interests of the masses of our people, the masses, my God, in this nation, oh God, that they may be concerned of the poor, oh God, in the name of Jesus, that they may be concerned, oh God, in the name of Jesus, of the resources, my God, of this nation in the name of Jesus, that they may want to see, my God, every single person prospering, God, that they may be concerned about people in our nation, God, having to have jobs in Jesus' mighty name, that they may be men and women of integrity, oh God, even as leaders, be men and women of integrity in those positions, oh God, and those, my God, that are planning to destroy this nation and to ravage this nation. Father, I pray that you remove them in the name of Jesus. I pray that you remove them from those positions of power. Father, I pray that you may remove them in the name of Jesus. And Father, I pray that you may bring forth men and women of integrity, men, oh God, that are willing, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, to serve this nation with distinction in Jesus' mighty name. Heavenly Father, I thank you, my God, that you are sweeping and cleaning. You are doing, my God, the only that which you can do, Lord, in Jesus' mighty name. I give you the praise. I give you the honor. I magnify your name. Lord, you are glorious, oh God. You never leave us nor forsake us. This nation, South Africa, will not be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Father, I pray that this nation, oh God, in Jesus' name, may not disintegrate, oh God. Father, you did a miracle in 1994. When we had the first president, oh God, being inaugurated in this nation. When we voted, my God, for the first time, Lord, in 1994, Lord, even as a nation, black and white. Heavenly Father, you did a miracle, oh God. And Lord, I believe that you are still going to do a miracle, even in this time, Lord, even in this generation, Lord, in the name of Jesus. I believe that you are still going to do a great work and a great miracle in Jesus' mighty name. South Africa is a nation that you love, oh God, in Jesus' mighty name. And I believe that the Egyptians that we are seeing today, the challenges that we are seeing today in this nation, we will see them no more in Jesus' name. Because, Lord, you're delivering this nation. Lord, the same way that you're delivering everyone that is praying and asking for deliverance right now, Lord, you are delivering, my God, this nation in the name of Jesus. Just like you're delivering our siblings, just like you're delivering, God, our parents, Lord, and just like you are delivering, my God, our relatives, Lord, you are delivering right now in the name of Jesus. This nation is a nation under you, Lord. This nation is a great southland of the Holy Spirit. This nation, oh God, in the name of Jesus, is a great land, oh God, that you want to do great things and great miracles with in Jesus' mighty name. And Heavenly Father, I pray, I also pray, even as I pray for this nation, I also pray for the peace of Jerusalem in Jesus' mighty name. I pray for the nation of Israel. I pray that Israel, oh God, in Jesus' name, may continue to be prosperous, oh God. I pray in Jesus' name that Israel may continue, oh God, to see your deliverance in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Protect the nation of Israel, oh God, in Jesus' mighty name. We give you the praise. We give you the honor. I pray for the peace of Jerusalem this morning in Jesus' mighty name. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for this day. Thank you that this is the day we are going to experience supernatural favor. This is the day we are going to experience your grace. This is the day, Lord, in the name of Jesus, we are going to experience your deliverance. And this is the day that you have made, that we may rejoice and be glad in it, in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father, for what you have done. And thank you for what you're doing this morning. In Jesus' mighty name, in Jesus' precious name, amen and amen. Hey, listen, somebody. Listen to me this morning, someone. The Bible says we prayed. The Bible says when we pray, we need to believe that we have received. And when we believe, we will have that which we have been asking God for. I believe today that everything that we have been saying to God, Lord, give it to us. We are asking for it. We're pleading, you know, for God to come through for us. God has done it for us. God has done it for us in the name of Jesus. We have received in the name of Jesus. We have received by faith. We have received by faith. God has come through for us in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you. Thank you. And thank you. Thank God this morning. But I want to also thank you for joining with us and pray and go out there in the world today and experience God's favor and God's blessing in everything that you will be doing this morning and everything that we'll be doing throughout the day. God is with you. God's hand is with you. And God will deliver you every day and every time in Jesus' name. God bless you. I love you all. And I will see you tonight at number 130 Plantation Road, Blue Hills, Midrand. And please come and join with us even as we meet in person. There is something about meeting in person, man. The presence of God just flows in there when we corporately pray. And so I encourage you to come tonight at 6:30 in the evening, right at our church building, and come and meet with me there. And we're going to have a great time even as we continue to pray. And God will meet our needs according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. I love you all. God bless you. Have a wonderful, wonderful day today in Jesus' name. Amen.